Hello friends, welcome to the channel. I am Poonam Dua from MN Education Academy of Literature. Today we are going to discuss a topic that is very important for literature students, Gayatri Spivak's notion of subalternity. This we will discuss in the form of her essay, Can the Subaltern Speak?, which is a landmark essay in the field of post-colonial studies. Please do not forget to share and subscribe the channel and press the bell icon in order to continue receiving important literary updates from this channel. Let us move to the topic now. We will try to know this writer first, Gayatri Chakravarti Spivak. Born 1942, at present she is around 78 years. She is one of the most influential figures in contemporary critical theory, and she is an Indian scholar, theorist and feminist critic as well. She is a leading contemporary feminist deconstructionalist who pays very careful attention to the issues of gender and race. She is perhaps best known for her overly political use of contemporary cultural and critical theories to challenge the legacy of colonialism. And this essay is in the same direction. Anyone interested in contemporary cultural theory should read Gayatri Chakravarti Spivak. Let us understand the term subaltern first. Her use of the term subaltern is influenced by the Italian thinker Antonio Gramsci. Gramsci consistently referred to a subordinate position in terms of class, gender, race and culture. Spivak's this essay, Can the Subaltern Speak?, addressed the way the subaltern, the subordinate, is constructed as absent or silent or somebody who is not listened to. The major argument in this essay is between patriarchy and imperialism. The figure of subaltern, specifically women, disappears. So, इस essay में सबसे basic argument यही है कि patriarchy और imperialism के बीच में कहीं ना कहीं subaltern की आवाज़ और दबकर रह जाती है, specifically women की. Spivak uses the term subaltern as the synonym of something of lower rank. कोई भी ऐसी रैंक जिसका कोई डिसीजन मेकिंग पावर नहीं होता, जिसके पास कोई एजेंसी नहीं होती. एंड स्पेसिफिकली शी कीप्स विमेन, ब्लैक्स एंड कॉलोनाइज इन दिस कैटेगरी. सबॉर्डिनेटी कम्स टू सजेस्ट दैट रिप्रेसिव डोमिनेंस ऑफ वाइट वेस्टर्न थिंकिंग एंड अ डिस्प्लेसमेंट ऑफ द जेंडर्ड एंड कॉलोनाइज. वेस्टर्न थॉट्स बेसिकली थर्ड वर्ल्ड की थॉट्स और इम्पोर्टेंस को सेकेंडरी ही ट्रीट करते हैं. वेस्टर्न थॉट्स मेक वेस्टर्न सुपीरियर and colonized inferior. Next, she raises a question. The next question that she raises is, how can the third world subject be studied without cooperation with the colonial project? She means, who gave the rights to so-called whites to study and examine the third world? Third world basically is a term which is often used to describe the developing countries like Africa, Asia and Latin America. So, बेसिकली वॉट शी इज सेइंग कि क्या थर्ड वर्ल्ड की खुद की कोई आइडेंटिटी, कोई पहचान नहीं है. सो स्पिविक बेसिकली पॉइंट्स टू द फैक्ट वाइट्स ऑलवेज मेक एन एफर्ट टू डिफाइन थर्ड वर्ल्ड बाय यूजिंग द टर्म अदर्स और समबडी ओवर देयर. सो दे कंसिडर देमसेल्स एज द सब्जेक्ट एंड द थर्ड वर्ल्ड एज एन ऑब्जेक्ट. बेसिकली वाइट मैन इज स्पीकिंग टू वाइट मैन अबाउट द कलर्ड मैन और वुमेन. मतलब ऐसा लगता है कि कोई रिसर्च चल रही है और रिसर्च का ऑब्जेक्ट है थर्ड वर्ल्ड और रिसर्च करने का राइट है वाइट्स के पास. स्पिविक सीम्स टू बी क्वाइट अपोज टू द वेस्टर्न अटेम्प्ट्स टू सिचुएट इटसेल्फ एज इन्वेस्टिगेटिंग सब्जेक्ट दैट इज अपोज टू द इन्वेस्टिगेटेड non-Western object. Spivak's answer to can the subaltern speak is no, they cannot. Not when the Western academic field is unable to relate to this so-called third world. While giving an example, she describes the circumstances surrounding the suicide of a young Bengali woman, Bhuvaneshwari Bhaduri. That indicates a failed attempt at self-representation. We will talk about this incident in detail in further part of this video. And next, she talks about the part of the British Sati Ban's failure in India that was due to a lack of subject involvement. So this essay basically argues that Sati Ban was failed in India because women were subaltern. This ban was described by her like white men saving brown women from brown men. but there was no role, no voice of brown women. She was subaltern. Spivak chooses the word sati. Sati women in India as a subaltern who cannot speak. According to Spivak, the word sati means a good wife and a Hindu female woman who is very loyal, very good, and she burns herself with her dead husband as well. So this was a proof of her loyalty. This practice was common among the Indian minorities in India, and Spivak argues that sati is an Indian ritual because according to the colonizer, it is a crime. And the colonizers claim that it is the social duty of them, of the white men, to save the brown women from the brown men. Finally, she ends her essay by answering her question. She states that the subaltern cannot speak because no one will listen to them. Let us understand this Bhuvaneshwari Bhaduri case now. She was a young woman of 16 or 17, Bhuvaneshwari Bhaduri. She hanged herself in North Calcutta in the year 1926, and this suicide at that point of time was a puzzle, since as Bhuvaneshwari was menstruating at that time, it was clearly not a case of illicit pregnancy. Nearly a decade later, after 10 years, around 10 years, it was discovered that she was a member of one of the many groups involved in the armed struggle for Indian independence, and she had finally been entrusted with a political assassination. So the actual motivation for Bhuvaneshwari's suicide was revealed years later. Her relatives discovered that she had been a member of a militant anti-colonial organization and had been given the responsibility of carrying out an assassination, but found herself unable to fulfill this task, this mission, for reasons that were never fully understood actually. Although Bhuvaneshwari kept these details to herself, she clearly wanted it to be known that whatever the motivation for the suicide might have been, it was not the shame of an illicit affair and its consequences. Because her attempts, Bhuvaneshwari's attempts at speaking outside normal patriarchal channels was not understood or supported, Spivak concluded that the subaltern cannot speak. For years, her family remained in the dark about the background of her act, knowing only that it was not because of pregnancy. It was the mystery that she left behind, and the family was clueless about her death, that Spivak offers as confirmation of the idea that the subaltern cannot speak. Spivak pointed out that Bhaduri was not in fact pregnant, and she said Bhaduri killed herself because she could not bear to take part in the political assassination. This woman was not heard and she could not even speak. She said this happened because she was defined only within the narrow limits of her gender, the stereotypical limits of her gender. She was a subaltern. So a key theme of Gayatri Spivak's work is agency. Agency means the ability of the individual to make their own decisions. While Spivak's main aim is to consider ways in which subalterns, which was her term for the deprived section of the society, subalterns were not able to achieve any kind of agency according to Spivak. And this video basically concentrates specifically on describing the ways in which Western scholars unintentionally produce hegemonic structures, dominating structures in their work, and the result is subaltern cannot speak. I hope you liked the video. Please do not forget to share and subscribe the channel. Thanks for watching. Best of luck for your exams. You may contact at the given number to join our online classes.